The lock date option is a great feature that enables you to close down periods and control who can and can't post transactions prior to a certain date. Let's have a look at how it works in the software. You can access lock date within three areas: the month end, year end, and also via the settings menu. Within settings, you choose lock date. This shows if it's switched on, and if it is, what lock date you've got set. Ours isn't switched on, so we'll tick the box and then select a date. So let's say we've run our month end at the end of September and we don't want anyone backdating transactions prior to that date. So we choose the 1st of October, click OK, and that's it set up. If we now try and backdate a transaction prior to that date, we'll see the message that appears. So we'll do that within bank accounts, and we'll enter a bank payment. We'll use the current account and then choose a date prior to the lock date. If we click back a month, and then we'll just choose a day in September. There's no message at this point, so we'll just continue entering the payment details. So you pop in a reference, ignore the extra reference, and then enter a nominal code. We'll leave the default department, ignore the project reference and the cost code, enter some details, an amount, and we'll accept the default tax code. Okay, so we're now ready to save the transaction, and a warning message appears prompting us that the transaction date is set before the current lock date. Do you wish to proceed and post to a lock date? So the important point here is that it's a warning and it gives us the choice. Do you wish to post it, yes or no? So we can proceed and post that transaction if required. So we'll just click yes, and the transaction posts. To stop people from getting the warning and then clicking yes to post the transaction anyway, if you go into settings, you can then amend their access rights. We'll just click yes to close the other windows. And for the purpose of this demonstration, we'll quickly create a new user. So we'll enter a username and a password. And we're going to leave them with full access at this stage, so they've got access to everything within the software. However, we're going to make one slight change, and that's within the settings menu. And then we're going to remove the lock date settings option. So that's the only change we're going to make. This user has full access but doesn't have access to the lock date settings. If we click OK, close out of the access rights, and we'll quickly log off and log in as the new user. So we'll file, log off, and then log in as the new user. If we now go and enter the same bank payment, so into bank accounts, and then bank payment, and we'll enter a similar bank payment to earlier. So we'll accept the default bank and then select the date prior to the lock date. So we can choose any date in September, and there's no message at this stage, but if we quickly enter the rest of the details, type in some details and a value, and this time when we save the transaction, rather than a warning message appear, this time it's an error. And the error states your transaction date is set before the current lock date. Tells us what that is. If the date is correct, please refer to your system administrator or accountant for advice on how to post to a lock date. We don't get the options, do you want to post this yes or no? This time we just get an OK option. So if we click OK, we're back to the bank payment details, and we can't save that transaction if the date remains prior to the lock date. As you can see, it's easy to control through the use of access rights who can and can't post transactions prior to a lock date. Let's clear the form, close out of the bank payment details, and we'll quickly log off as the new user and log back in as manager, or as a user who has access to the lock date settings on the settings menu. You can access the lock date setting at any time just by opening the settings menu and then choosing lock date. As you can see, you can switch it on and off at any time, and also if you do have it switched on, you can amend the date at any time as well.